Thanks.
No worries. Thanks for letting Brendan stay.
Well, he's our landlord, so I couldn't exactly say no, could I?
Well, you know what I mean. Agreeing to it in the circumstances.
I'm in a wheelchair. I'm not deaf.
Stop being paranoid. Right, we're talking about the deli, aren't we?
Yeah, so there's still one condition to this.
Oh.
Well, I think you're making him a little bit hot under the collar dressed like that, so maybe it's a good idea to put some clothes on.
Oh, yeah.
Of course.
Hiya. All right, so apparently the police are organising a search party to find baby Bobby, and they need as many volunteers as possible to help, so...
I'm in. What are you looking at me like that for? I'm in.
Well, you're in no fit state to help anyone, are you?
No. But we can both go, though.
What?
We can't leave Brendan on his own, can we?
He'll be fine.
Yeah, because he was really fine on the floor in his flat. No, one of us is going to have to stay here with him.
Yeah, you're right.
I know how you feel about him, so I'll just stay.
No, you go. You go, and I'll stay here, and I'll keep an eye on him.
Are you sure?
Mm-hmm. Right, well, I'm gonna make something to eat. Are you hungry?
Always. Any word from Stephen? Maybe you should call him, see if he's safe, see if he's okay.
Of course he'll be okay.
Thank you for that.
Not a problem.
You don't have to, you know.
After what?
Be so nice to me.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Your boyfriend's ex is living with you. I wouldn't blame you if you felt threatened.
Well, you're wrong on two counts there, because one, Steve is not my boyfriend, he is my fiancé. And two, I don't feel threatened in the slightest. Catch up. Is that okay?
They don't look good for my taste, but it's all right.
I'll try and remember for next time.
Really thought Stephen would be back by now.
Why all the interest in how long he's been out?
Well, you know me, Douglas. I'm a born warrior. What?
You're not worried about Steve. You're obsessed with him. And it's fine. Go ahead. But you need to remember me and Steve are engaged now.
And you need to remember that I'm really happy for you both. Really, I am. I'll be honest, I wasn't too thrilled when he told me in the hospital. You didn't know he told me, did you?
You were injured and he came to see you, so what? He doesn't have to tell me everything.
Still strange, though, isn't it?
Brendan, you really do bring out the worst in people. I've tried so hard to be nice to you all day, but there's only so much a man can take, so you know what? You're out of here.
You're kicking me out.
Oh, you got it in one. Good job.
I ain't going anywhere, Douglas.
Do you know what, Brendan? You deserve everything that happens to you. I mean, look at you. You're in a wheelchair, and I'm glad. I'm glad that bad things happen to bad people. I mean, you've been so worried about Steve today when you still don't get it. You're cancerous. The further away you are from him, the safer he'll be.
All right, well, there's still no sign of him. What's going on?
I decided to go home.
No. Have you said something to him?
No, he hasn't said anything. It's my decision. Seriously, Stephen, come on. You know me. I don't like being dependent on anyone.
Brenda, what if you fall out your chair again, eh?
Then I'll call you. Promise. I'm going home.
Right, well, I'm coming with you then.
Oh, hang on.
You can't get up them steps on your own.
You're a cop?
Yeah.
No, prove it.
Been placed undercover to take Brady down. But he's slippery.
You don't have to tell me that.
And he's dangerous. We need to take him off the streets.
Okay, look, I agree with everything you're saying, all right? But where do I fit in?
You don't need to know the details now. Are you in or out?
Yeah, hey, it's me. I need your services. Tomorrow? Yeah, I'll be there.